After being caught red-handed with her stepson in bed, Gloria Grahame was immediately divorced by her husband. But that wouldn't stop her from dating and eventually marrying her stepson. However, once this was found out by the press, everything she had built was shattered into pieces. Also, only a small percentage of the people who watch my videos are actually subscribed. So if you end up liking this video, consider subscribing. It's free, and you can always change your mind. Enjoy the video. Who exactly was Gloria Grahame? Gloria Grahame was born in 1923 in Los Angeles, California. During Gloria's childhood and adolescence, her mother taught her acting at home. Grahame would then attend Hollywood High School before dropping out to pursue acting. She made an early stage appearance in the long-running farce Good Night, Ladies at Chicago's Blackstone Theater starring Buddy Ebsen, which opened on the 12th of April, 1942. Grahame made her first Broadway appearance on December 6th, 1943 at the Royal Theater as Florrie in Nunnally Johnson's The World's Full of Girls. This was an adaptation from Thomas Bell's 1943 novel, Till I Come Back to You. She was eventually discovered by Louis B. Mayer after he saw her performance and quickly got signed to a contract with MGM Studios under her professional name after. Grahame made her film debut in the 1944 movie Blonde Fever and then achieved one of her most widely praised roles as the flirtatious Violet Bick, saved from disgrace by George Bailey in It's a Wonderful Life. MGM was not able to make her a national star, and her contract was sold to RKO Studios in 1947. She was then often featured in film noir pictures as a tarnished beauty with an irresistible sexual allure. During this time, she made films for several Hollywood studios. She also received an Oscar nomination for Best Supporting Actress for Crossfire in 1947. Grahame then starred with Humphrey Bogart in the film In a Lonely Place for Columbia Pictures, a performance for which she gained a lot of praise. Though today it is considered among her finest performances, it was not a box office hit, and Howard Hughes, the owner of RKO, admitted that he never saw the film. When she asked to be lent out for roles in Born Yesterday and A Place in the Sun, Hughes refused, and instead appeared in a supporting role in Macau. Despite only appearing for a little over 9 minutes on screen, she won the Academy Award for Best Supporting Actress in MGM's The Bad and the Beautiful. With this, she also held the record for the shortest performance on screen to win an acting Oscar. Insecurity and rudeness canceled her. Grahame later appeared as a wealthy seductress, Harriet Lang, in Not as a Stranger, starring big Hollywood names such as Olivia de Havilland, Robert Mitchum, and Frank Sinatra. Grahame also did her own stunts as Angel the Elephant Girl in Cecil B. DeMille's The Greatest Show on Earth. The movie won the Oscar for Best Picture in 1952. Grahame's career started to wane after her performance in the musical film Oklahoma. During that time, she was rumored to have been difficult on the set, upstaging some of the cast and alienating her co-stars. She began a slow return to the theater and appeared in films occasionally to play supporting roles, mostly in minor releases. She also guest starred in television series, including the science fiction series The Outer Limits. In the episode of that series titled The Guess, Grahame plays a forgotten film star living in the past. Grahame can also be seen in a 1970 episode of Mannix titled Duet for Three, and in a small role in the miniseries Rich Man, Poor Man, and Seventh Avenue. Over time, Grahame became increasingly concerned with her physical appearance. She particularly felt her upper lip was too thin and had ridges that were too deep. She began stuffing cotton or tissues under it. She felt this gave her a sexier look. Several co-stars discovered this during kissing scenes. Grahame began undergoing small cosmetic procedures on her lips and face ever since the 1940s. According to her niece, Vicki Mitchum, Graham's obsession with her looks led her to undergo more cosmetic procedures that rendered her upper lip largely immobile because of nerve damage. Robert Mitchum even claimed that over the years, Grahame carved herself up trying to make herself into an image of beauty she felt should exist but didn't. Others saw her as a beautiful person, but she never did. Personal life. Grahame was married 4 times and had 4 children. Her first marriage was to actor Stanley Clements in August 1945. They divorced just 2 years later, however. And just one day after her divorce from Clements was made final, Graham married director Nicholas Ray. They had a son, Timothy, in November 1948. After several separations and reconciliations, Graham and Ray divorced in 1952. Graham's third marriage was to writer and television producer Cy Howard. They married in August 1954. They had a daughter in 1956. Graham filed for divorce from Howard in May 1957, citing he was mentally cruel to her. Their divorce was made final in November 1957. Graham's fourth and final marriage was to actor Anthony Ray, who was the son of her second husband, Nicholas Ray. Anthony was her former stepson. According to Nicholas Ray, in June 1951, he caught her in bed at their Malibu home with Tony, his 13-year-old son from his first marriage, who just returned from military school. It was the kind of thing Gloria Grahame, the actress, would have done in her movies, says biopic director Paul McGugin. The gossip tsunami this tryst generated would only be exceeded 9 years later when Grahame's former partner and biographer Peter Turner has disputed this, saying that the story of Tony being underage when Graham began a relationship with him was all made up. Graham and Anthony Ray reconnected in 1958 and married in Tijuana, Mexico in May 1960. The couple went on to have two children. But in the beginning, news of the marriage was kept private until 1962, when it was written about in the tabloids. The ensuing scandal damaged Graham's reputation and affected her career. After learning of her marriage to Anthony Ray, Graham's third husband, Cy Howard, attempted to gain sole custody of the couple's daughter, Mariana. Howard claimed Graham was an unfit mother, and the two fought over custody of Mariana for years. The stress of the scandal, her waning career, and her custody battle with Howard took its toll on Graham, and she had a nervous breakdown. She later underwent electroshock therapy in 1964. Despite the surrounding scandal, Graham's marriage to Anthony Ray was her only one of four to last well beyond 4 years, and they did not divorce until a few days short of their 14th anniversary in May 1974. After that, Graham had a relationship with Peter Turner. Turner authored a book about his relationship with Graham called The Film Stars Don't Die in Liverpool, which was later turned into a movie with the same name. Refusing treatment. In March 1974, Graham was diagnosed with breast cancer. She underwent radiation treatment, changed her diet, stopped smoking and drinking alcohol, and also sought homeopathic remedies. In less than a year, cancer went into remission. However, it did return back in 1980. But Graham refused to acknowledge her diagnosis or seek radiation treatment. Choosing instead to continue working, she traveled to the United Kingdom to appear in a play. Her health, however, declined rapidly. She developed periodontitis after undergoing a procedure to remove fluid from her abdomen in September 1981. In the autumn of 1981, while performing at the Duke's in Lancaster, England, Graham was taken ill. The local hospital wanted to perform surgery immediately, but she refused. Contacting her former lover, actor Peter Turner, she requested to live in Liverpool at the home of Turner's mother, where she would remain for 6 days. Graham requested that Turner not contact medical people or her family, but Turner did so, and he was concerned about her health. The doctor told Graham that she had a cancerous tumor in her abdomen the size of a football. She then returned to New York City, where she passed away in October 1981 at the age of 57. Leave a like if you enjoyed this video, and check out the next video in this series.